a huge match for him. Well, he's won his first 2 points here. There's a bit of an issue with the scoring machine. I'm going to have to get the official over to disrupt the play here. Needs must, but not ideal, really, when you're at the start of the match. Play can resume. 0-2. Ashalmanian with his first two serves of the match.
1-2.
Not surprised to see him win the point. He's such a good server.
One, two.
He's a feared player. No one really wants to play Noshad Almanian because he's so dodgy, so awkward. And the tactic seems obvious to play it into his forehand, but protects it so well. Survived the initial one, but not the second. Too much to ask of the Iranian there. Dominant play on display from the Romanian. Didn't have a clue what was on that, did he, Edward Ionescu? Snaps through the fingers with that backhand so wonderfully. Got him from a bad position into a very good one, that shot. Turn the tide with that one stroke. Well, he's doing okay with the receive here. But Noshad a point away from levelling. Always varying it, and he's got such a wide range of serves as well, Almanian. There he does the reverse. Great receive, but a nice bit of pinpoint play from the Iranian. Spinning. And then, not fully behind it, but still good contact and into a decent place. Levels it up. Never feel comfortable against this man. He wins points so seamlessly. So under the radar, but that one took off like a helicopter.
Eight, 10.
which is really, really impressive here, I must admit. Coming into this tie, I did not expect Noshad Amanian to lose both of his matches. I thought he was very capable of winning both, which goes to show how much they've really tried to study the hand switch wizard. Chipping away at the wall there, wasn't it? Finally came crumbling down. He hammered it down. Oh, look at that for a serve. He comes into it and uses so much body that you don't think it's possible that he's going to play such a slow serve, but that is the magic of it. Could make a big difference, because now it's going to be Ionescu that has to chase, and Alamian has the serve. Well, this wide one is working well, because what it does is it opens up the table, and then Alamian can play his necessary shot, his backhand, and dominate more with it. This could be the right way. Looks like it's going to be an even there. Had a movement to make. Such a good serve. And look at it. I mean, he has to have a backhand of this level to compensate for the lack of the forehand. Again, for those of you that aren't aware of why he doesn't want the forehand, he has a condition that 1 in 1,000 people are affected by. He can't feel any sensation because of the damage to the nerves in his hand. Only when he plays the forehand. Must be something about the angle of it, the way his hand has to be, the forehand, that this isn't possible. What an inspiring fighter he is. Can't afford to be sympathetic here if you're Ionescu, though. Smashing backhand there from Ionescu. He really has to be in position to play it like that, though. Insane. Even a little forehand tomahawk chop block in there. And that was only one string to the bow of that rally. So 5 game points here to Noshad Alamian. Okay. Sends it up. Hand switch smash ready, but doesn't need to use it. First point of game three to Edward Ionesco. Hand switch dink, back to his backhand. It's just such an amazing talking point. Look at that. Oh, what a block. Him flying in and flying back. Just brace for impact. Different feeling to this match now. The eyes of Almanian have softened it. And that's concerning for Ionesco. The last second kick there on that side's been served. He has to guess more than any other player. And that's because of the time it takes to transition to put his bat in his other hand. That in itself shows what a genius he is, because table tennis is a sport that you barely have any time as it is, and his anticipation has to be that much better to make up for that loss in time. WTT social media pages. Right out of the timeout there, Almanian winning the point with that serve again. Block went into the net there. Less topspin on it than what he thought. It kind of drove it more, came through it more. Didn't spin up that one as much. Ionescu has a more driven technique, really. He does take his forehand a little bit later to get more spin than quite a lot of players do. That could be a bit of a European characteristic that he's got. Almanian's backhand is more spinny, it's less powerful but more archy. That's a good thing because it gives him the time. Three game points here, this is crucial. Crucial for the Iranians. It's their main man on a mission. On the brink of going 2-1 up. great push. Nice blocking, but that is unplayable. The power of that backhand. Crazy, crazy cut. It's a backhand that's helped him take down Europe, the European legend Dmitry Ovcharov at the European Games. But on the world stage, it's this man right here. Cracks it. Well, you can now hear how much effort they're putting in. Can help you get a bit of rhythm actually when you grunt. Nice little shimmies. It's good play. What a receive. It's not often you see him make a forehand winner. That is an anomaly right there. Feeling, oh wow, immense. Let the fun commence. Exhibition stuff, but this is in reality far from that. When there's already so much spin on the ball, it takes a lot of feeling to get it back. Himself into each and every shot here, Edward Ionescu. Distancing himself perfectly from the table to give himself more time to play those big shots. Oh! By his standards, that is a howler. He's just trying to reset and keep his chin up. This is concerning here.
Bravo.
6-5.
Into a decent location there, and Armanian got stuck. So important you don't put it into an area where he can play that backhand as comfortably. Make him have to move first, at least. Don't think he fully read the serve as intended, but still. Very awkward ball for Noshad to do anything with there.
Go!
Ooh. Side or edge. There's going to be another contest in this one.
No, it was not touched. It was not touched. It was not touched.
No touch.
No touch. No touch. No, no. No touch.
Was it?
6-10.
Were they not outside the table? Did it hit any of the playing surface?
It was no touch. Umpire.
Freeze.
It was the side.
Romanians don't look too sure.
Was not touch.
It appears to be side. Definitely appears to be side.
6-10. Please play on.
He is disgusted, Alamia. And he's lost the game. We're going to yet another. This would be the second time that Armanian has lost from 2-1 up in this tie. Very testing times it. Feels like the closer you stay, the less chance you have. So if you do go back, you have to play it with power and aggression. This is turning into a dream here for the Romanians. Ooh. You never know where it's going to go when he does decide to play it. And he thinks the only option is for me to do it, he will do it, but obviously he doesn't want that. Wow, what a topsy-turvy point. Beautiful. Stunning. Well, well, well. That's why you should always fight, because can force a couple of errors, all of a sudden you're back. He's done it. He's levelled. Hat trick from the magician Alamia. Well, it'll be ahead of the change of ends here. But fasten your seatbelts, because there is still some distance to go.
5-4.
Change of pace, blocking, amazing backhand again. Such a spectacular shot, isn't it? Reminiscent of a Kalinikos Kuryanga. Different technique, but the power, I mean, man, what do you do against that? What can you do? Doing really well to change the pace here, the Iranian. Turning into an epic of a fifth game. refrain from cheering there, the Romanian bench, because get a bit of fortune there, Edward. Shuffle serve, he gets it back. That was a great third ball flick as well. It's hanging him. Got his serves as well. One that Amanian would have never have expected himself to miss. But it is a moment of high drama, of high tension here. 6-9. Another one. He's matched him. In this department of the game in Romania here have four opportunities, four bites of the apple. To close the curtains on Iran.